Peter Martoni.
Nice to meet you, Peter.
Nice to meet you also. Thanks. We want me to show you what we're going to set up?
Sure.
All right, fantastic.
You got that?
Yeah, I'd like to. Let me show you.
Okay.
Right, we're going to come right in here.
Okay.
And this is what... primary doctor, and the primary doctor sends them to somebody that the primary doctor knows to send them to, and they send them to a psychiatrist. And what are the tools of a psychiatrist? Well, the tools are you can use your mouth to talk to the child and coach the family. It takes a lot of time to do that. Or you can do a quicker approach, which is medication. Does medication work? Yes. What medication does is it will change the brain function of the child and will settle a child down. So if you're looking at a society that we look for a quick fix, medication is definitely your answer, because you can give a child, unknowing, unbeknownst to the side effects of that medication, you give that child that medication, the parent will see a calmer Johnny. And it seems like, okay, this is great, and then eventually we'll take the child off of the medication and the child will be fine, when in fact, that's not what you see.
When you say works, define that a little more about what you mean by works. I mean, you said he'll be quieter. Is that really what we're after, or should we be getting to the underlying physical cause, if there is one, to what's going on with little Johnny, and remedy that? Because isn't the drug just covering that over, and you still have that problem underneath that's just going to continue to get worse unless you address it? Can you talk about that?
Yeah, you know, we're in a society that a symptom, you know, pain is a gift that nobody wants. It's a gift. It tells you that there's something's wrong. When a child is acting out, you have to listen to that. It's not, that's just not a mere coincidence. There's something that's going wrong. Now, we take, you know, for pain, what do we take? We could take an aspirin. We could take an Advil. We could take an oxycodone. You know, will that get rid of the pain? Yes. But will it get rid of the problem? No. And that's exactly what psychiatric medication does. Will it get rid of the symptom of the child acting up? Sometimes. But does it just push the problem deeper and deeper and deeper, and you do not have to deal with it in the long run? Absolutely not. Eventually, you are still going to have to deal with the problem.
Cool. What are some of the long-term effects that we might see in children from these psychiatric drugs?
Is it going to be effect? I can tell you, based on chemistry, absolutely yes. Can I tell you if it's going to be, you know, can I tell you specifically what's going to happen? No, but I can tell you that the development of that body is going to be affected. And there's no way to predict the long-term side effects of what's going to happen to that child. So when I see on a psychiatric, you know, a psychiatric medication bottle, side effects, you have to remember they are not side effects. They are effects. And that's a very important point to make. Just because it might not be your desired outcome, it is still an effect.
Now, this person that's off the medication, they were put on a medication for a reason. Does that reason now resurface and so now you have the same problem again? Or do you delve in and try and handle whatever that was attempting to handle to begin with?
when you're working with a child that has behavioral problems, not all of them, but a lot of them, most of the problems start at home. And what I mean by that is our parenting styles, how we talk to our children, how we talk to our spouse. If you are not willing to accept responsibility for little Johnny's not going to be able to get better.
So you mentioned diet. Are diet and nutrition a mainstay, a reason that occurs more often than not as an underlying situation for these behaviors?
Regardless if you like it or not, what you put into your system, your body is going to either respond favorable or negative. A child that has learning difficulties or mental, unquote, you know, psychiatric disorder, you have to look at the GI tract. You have to look at what you're putting into that child's system. If you're inundating that child with hot dogs, chicken nuggets, processed foods, how is that child going to be able to function effectively? You can't.
Good. So by drugging our children, are we drugging the future?
By drugging our children, absolutely, we are drugging our future. You could be drugging, you know, crane operators. You could be drugging the next doctor. I mean, do you want a medical doctor who is a surgeon on psychiatric medication? Do you want that? Why would you want little Johnny on it?
She'd still have her son today.
You know, this is along the same lines. I met a woman in California a couple of years ago. Little Wyatt had a child, little Wyatt. Little Wyatt had an ear infection. They took little Wyatt to the pediatrician. Wyatt was 9 months old. And they gave Wyatt an antibiotic. Wyatt Lehman died 5 weeks later from the antibiotic. What that mother said to me, and it stick in my mind from this point for the rest of my life, if your voice was louder and I knew what I knew now, my child would still be alive right now. That drives me every single day to do what I do. And my voice is going to get louder. Is what people don't realize is what controls everything in the human body? Your brain. And your brain does so through your nervous system. Every cell, everything in the human body is controlled by the central nervous system. So how important is it that your nervous system functions optimally from this day and for the rest of your life? That is extremely important. In the structure of your spine protects your central nervous system. So your spine being out of alignment, or if there's interference in that system due to pressure from a bone, that can significantly affect the way that body can develop. So it is extremely important to make sure that your nervous systems function optimally, and a chiropractor should be in your team of professionals when you're trying to take little Johnny off of medication. The future.
That's great. What is the wonderfulness of children?
Children are our future. Every child that's running around in the playground, their innocence is breathtaking. It's beautiful. A child doesn't know failure. A child doesn't know right or wrong. A child doesn't know what to eat. We teach them. We are their parents. We're their guide through life. And as a guide or as a parent, you have a responsibility. You brought a child into this world. You have a responsibility to guide that child through the world in your best manner possible. So educate yourself how to parent a child. And if you don't know how to parent yourself, educate yourself on how to parent yourself and then parent the child. Because a child is innocent. They don't know right or wrong. You teach them right or wrong.
Cool. That's all I have.